friends, I can't believe we are already in week number 6 of Miss Wonderly Makes Music at Home. I'm Miss Wonderly, and I'm coming to you live from my living room, ready to sing, dance, read, play, and make music with you. Now, before we get started, there's 2 things we gotta remember. First, leave your in the comments below, let me know who's here. I would love to know who's here, where you're from, who's in your music making crew today. So leave that in the comments below. Number 2, parents, if you're watching this with your kiddos this week, I would love for you to take pictures and videos and send them to me. One of the joys of being a music teacher is getting to see your students make music right in front of you. And obviously, that's not really possible right now. So I've loved all the pictures and videos I've received so far. So keep sending those my way and we'll have some fun today. Okay, time for our hello songs. Get those waving arms ready. Here we go. You got one more chance, so get that arm. We're going back and forth, keeping the steady beat. Are you ready? Here we go. Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? How are you today? Now remember, our second song is kind of repeat after me, but it's kind of together, which means that I'll go first and you follow. Welcome to music. We're gonna do some singing. We're gonna do some singing. We're gonna use our ears. We're gonna use our ears. We're going to have a lot of fun, 'cause music time has just begun. Welcome to music. Welcome to music. Glad you're here. Glad you're here. Oh, I am so, so, so glad that you are here today making music with me, because the more we get together, 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 the more we get together, the happier we'll be. 'Cause your friends are my friends, and my friends are your friends. The more we get together, the happier we'll be. Speaking of bees, our story of the day today is called Buzz, Buzz, Busy Bees. And it's all about what happens when the bees start flying away from their friends and they're getting up to something. So let's see what those bees are up to on the farm this week. So sit back, relax. Here's Buzz, Buzz, Busy Bees. Our story of the day is Buzz, Buzz, Busy Bee by Melanie Gerth. And it's brought to us by Simon & Schuster Publishing. We want to thank Simon & Schuster for allowing teachers and librarians all over the world to share their stories during this time. Here we go. Cock-a-doodle-doo, says the rooster. Do you want to play? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. I'm too busy today. I wonder what he's busy doing. How many bees are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's see what happens next. One of the bees flew away. Oink, oink, says Pig. Would you like to have some fun? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. I really have to run. I wonder where this bee's gonna go. There he goes. Nay, nay, says Horse. Will you race me through the grass? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. I'm afraid I'll have to pass. I wonder where that bee's gonna go. Moo, moo, says Cow. Can you join me in the hay? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. I must be on my way. Quack, quack, says Duck. Will you watch me swim around? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. Not when there are flowers to be found. Woof, woof, says Dog. Shall we chase the butterflies? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. I have to make a sweet surprise. I wonder what that sweet surprise is going to be. A cake? We'll see. Ribbit, ribbit, says Frog. Want to see me jump and splash? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. Right now, I have to dash. Where are all of these bees going? How many do we have left? 1, 2, 3. There goes one more. Meow, meow, says Cat. Want to play some peekaboo? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. I've got other things to do. Where are all of these bees going? Bah, bah, says Sheep. Can you watch me jump the gate? Bzz, bzz, says Bee. Right now, I'm running late. Now there are no bees left. Chirp, chirp, says the bird. Bees are buzzing all about. What are they busy doing? Let's go find out. Wonder what they've been up to this whole time. Mmm, says the farmer. Honey, golden as the sun. Thanks, busy bees, for a job well done. Bzz, bzz, says the bees. We've made honey all day. Now we are finished and ready to play. They made a bunch of honey, didn't they? They were so busy. That's the end of our story. Let's get back to our lesson. Those were some busy bees, weren't they? And what were they busy making? Honey, that's exactly right. Now, I've got a bee friend right here who's been a little bit busy. And this busy bee likes to fly up and down and up and down. Do you think we can make our voice match my bee friend right here? When the bee flies up, we have to go up. When the bee goes down, our voice has to go down too. Do you think we could do it? Here we go. Ooh. Great job. I wonder if we could do something a little bit different. Let's see if it'll be tricky this time. Let's watch him. Ooh. Great job. Now this busy buzzy bee likes to fly a lot of different places, and I have a song that I like to sing about this busy buzzy bee, and it goes like this. Are you ready? Busy buzzy busy bee, buzzing around from tree to tree. Busy buzzy busy bee, don't you dare to buzz near me. Do you think you could sing that with me? Listen again. Busy buzzy busy bee, buzzing around from tree to tree. Busy, buzzy, busy bee. Don't you dare to buzz near me. Do you think you could make your bee move up and down like my bee while we sing? You can maybe put it in your fingertips like this and go up and down with your voice while we sing. Here we go. Busy, buzzy, busy bee. Buzzing around from tree to tree. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, don't you dare to buzz near me. Which word was the highest word? Listen this time again. See if you can figure out which word is the highest word in our song. Here we go. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, buzzing around from tree to tree. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, don't you dare to buzz near me. Don't was our highest word, isn't it? Now, sometimes I like to go tell my friends about this bee. When I tell my friends about this bee, I look at them like this and I say, bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. What does snout mean? Snout is like a nose, isn't it? And if we say the words, I declare that you are out, sounds like it's going to be a game, doesn't it? Well, let's learn it again to make sure we've got it in our brains, and then I'll teach you the game. Here we go. Bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. Do you think you could do it one more time? This time, keep the steady bee on your knees while we say it. Are you ready? What voice are we using? Our talking voice. And it's not our singing voice anymore, is it? It's our talking voice. Here we go. Bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. Do you think you could keep the steady beat somewhere else? You pick a new spot. I'm going to use my shoulders, but maybe you pick something different. Here we go. Bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. Do you think we could put our singing voice and our talking voice together? We'll sing our busy, buzzy bee song And then our bumblebee poem. Do you think we could do it together? Get your bees ready. Here we go. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, buzzing round from tree to tree. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, don't you dare to buzz near me. Bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. Great job. Now I'm going to teach you how to play the game. Earlier today, I played it, so I've got a video that's going to describe it a little bit better for you, but it's kind of like the apple tree game that we played a few weeks ago. All you have to do is get a bunch of friends together, or, you know, when you're stuck at home with maybe your stuffed animals, you can get your stuffed animals together in a circle, and you can play the game that way. So take a look. Hey, friends. Now, we've played a game similar to this before when we were talking about our apple tree song, but this week we're going to play it with bumblebees. So the first thing you've got to do is either get your family together in a circle, or you can circle up your stuffed animals just like I did right here. And so you're going to get those stuffed animals in a circle, and then you're going to make a prediction. And a prediction is when you try to decide how you think it's going to turn out. So I'm going to pick an animal that I think might win this game. And I think I'm going to pick the duck this week. I'm going to see if the duck will win the game. I don't know how it's going to turn out, but that's my prediction. That's my guess. So now it's time to sing our Busy Buzzy Bee song. So you can sing the song first if you want, just to start it off. And remember, it goes like this. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, buzzing round from tree to tree. Busy, buzzy, busy bee, don't you dare to buzz near me. Now that's the song, but the game is played with the speaking part. And it goes like this. I'm going to start my finger somewhere in the circle. Let's start with the cat. And I'm going to keep that steady beat on the top of my puppets or my stuffed animals as I say the poem. And it goes like this. Bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. So it landed on the octopus, so he's out. Let's try again and see what happens next. Bee, bee, bumblebee, stung a man upon his knee, stung a pig upon his snout. I declare that you are out. Oh, there goes the bunny. Let's keep playing and see what happens. Wasn't that fun? Now, let's see if we can figure out the rhythm of our poem. Remember, the rhythm is the way the words go. So we're going to say just the speaking part, just our poem, and see if we can figure out the rhythm. Let's do the first line first. Bee, bee, bumblebee. Can you clap and say that with me? Bee, bee, bumblebee. So that's the way the words go. I'm going to point to the beats on the board, and let's see if we can figure out which beat has two sounds. Can we figure it out? Here we go. Bee, bee, bumblebee. Will you clap it one more time? Which one has two sounds in it? Here we go. Bee, bee, bumblebee. Which one was it? It was that third box again, isn't it? That third box really likes to have two sounds in it. So I'm going to put my card with two B's on there because it had two sounds. If that one had two sounds, how many did the other ones have? Just one, isn't that right? So we have a beat that has two sounds, and we have three beats with one sound. Let's see our BB bumblebee part again and make sure that matches. Here we go. B, B, bumblebee. That's exactly right. Now, the first week we talked about rhythm, we used the words walk and tiptoe, but last week we learned some new words. Do you remember what those are called? Ta and ti-ti. How many sounds are in the word ta? One sound. So when we want to show the word ta or the note ta, all we're going to do right now is draw one line, and that means ta. That's exactly right. Now, we have this one that has two sounds in it. And that can't be ta, because ta only has one sound. So instead, we're going to use the note tt. But when we draw tt, we can't just draw two lines. Because if we just drew two lines, this would look like ta, 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 ta. And that's not right. So instead, we have to connect those two lines together. So we know that it's something different. Now we have ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Can you say that? Ready and go. Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Exactly right. So that sounds like B, B, bumble, B. Let's see if we can figure out the next phrase with the rhythm. I wonder if it's the same or if it's different. Let's find out. Actually, I think we're going to skip just to the last phrase. Let's do the last one. I declare that you are out. Can you clap that? Ready and go. I declare that you are out. You say it and clap it. I'll point to our beat boxes and let's see if we can figure out which boxes have two beats and which boxes have one beat, or not one beat, one sound. Which box has two sounds and which box has one sound? Here we go. I declare that you are out. Was that the same or different? It was different, wasn't it? I think that there's only one box that has one sound. Can you figure out which one it is? Here we go. I declare that you are out. Which one had one sound? It was the last box. That's different than the other beat. So if that one has one sound, how many sounds do these three have? Two sounds. Do you remember what we call those beats that have two sounds? What do we call them? TT. So I'm gonna draw two lines and connect them at the top, just like that. And what do we call the beat that has one sound? Ta. Great job. Can you read this for me? Here we go. Ti, 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 ta. Now let's say I declare that you are out and see if that matches. Here we go. I declare that you are out. It does match, doesn't it? Great job. Now, those two songs are not the only songs that were written about bumblebees. There's actually a lot of songs that people have written about bumblebees. And there's a composer, a very famous composer, named Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov, who was from Russia. And he wrote a song called The Flight of the Bumblebee. Now let me tell you a little bit about Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov. He was born in 1844 in Russia. But what's interesting about Nikolai is that he was really good at music when he was a little kid, but he actually went to school and college to study math and science. He didn't really go to be a musician, and he eventually joined the Navy in Russia. But while he was growing up and when he was 17, he met another famous composer, and he really started to think about studying music again, and he eventually became a professor at a conservatory or a college called St. Petersburg Conservatory. And while he was a professor, which is another word for teacher, he started to write music too. He started to become a composer. And one of the songs he wrote was called The Flight of the Bumblebee. And this song is supposed to sound like really fast little bees zooming all about. And he originally wrote it for an orchestra, but a different composer came back and they made that music fit a piano where you could play all of the parts all by yourself just on a piano. And I got permission from a company called Rousseau, who's a YouTube, has a YouTube channel with lots of awesome music videos on it. And Rousseau gave me permission to share their version of The Flight of the Bumblebee, which I think you'll really enjoy because you can see just how fast their fingers move and you can see all of the notes they're playing light up right above it. So sit back, relax. Here is Flight of the Bumblebee. Thank you. Oh my goodness, that was so fast, wasn't it? I can't believe that those fingers can move so fast. Now even I can play piano, but I can't play piano that fast. That was crazy. Be sure to check out Rizzo's YouTube channel for lots of other awesome music videos just like that after our lesson is over today. Okay, friends, it's time for us to get moving and grooving. And our friends at Cuckoo Kangaroo are giving us a double dose of moving today. The first is one of their songs called Be Over There, and I thought it would be perfect for our lesson today. It's a music video all about bees. But right after that, we've got one more dance along today. So we're gonna get our bodies moving and grooving. Stand up, stretch, and let's get ready for some Cuckoo Kangaroo. It is already time for us to go. But before we leave, I've got an at-home challenge just for you. And this at-home challenge is special this week because we're actually going to be using it in our lesson next week. So our at-home challenge is to learn the cup game pattern. Some of you may have seen this cup pattern in some recent movies and in songs, but it sounds a little something like this. Now, I don't have a cup right here in front of me, so it won't look exactly like that. But that cup pattern is going to be important for our lesson next week. So I've included a video in the comments below, and I'll include it in the description once this video is over, of ways that you can learn that cup pattern and do your best. You won't be perfect at it, and that is just okay. So we're going to use it next week, though, as part of our lesson. So do your best to see if you can figure it out this week. That's your at-home challenge. Okay, it's time for us to go. But before we leave, first, I want to say hi to my friends at Two Lakes High students. I love you. I miss you. You've been pushing through this, and I am so proud of you. Thank you for continuing to make music a priority. I love, love, love seeing you here every week. It's time to go, but before we leave, we got a song to sing. It goes like this. Peace and love till I see you again. wash your hands, keep them away from your face. I'll see you next week making music in our space. Bye, friends. Thank you so much for coming to music every week. I love, love, love spending this time with you. See you later.